Hello, everybody. Hello, it's Tuesday night, and we have a Kerbals. We have Kerbals, and I have headphones, and I have things to talk about, and we have McThulu, Dr. Trotter, TK0423, Soxars. Soxarsis? Soxarsirius? I don't know. We have people here, and we're going to do some stuff. You probably saw my video earlier in the day, so yeah, I figure that this is a good time for me to wait a second, let me adjust my... I just noticed that this had been clearly messed up by somebody, probably kids. Damn kids. Plank unit time. Wait, plank time is spelt with a CK, right? Yeah. Yeah, what's this host mode thing? By the way, I got this chocolate biscuit here, which I'm just like, oh, I'm so... Oh, chocolate. Love me some chocolate. Oh, yeah. So yeah, you might have seen my video today about rocket cars, and since we have reached a world where engines are working and everything, seems like something to look at, right? So, I kind of wanted to go in, actually, if I go in, let me just hold this, can I F9? Let's do this. Taco Bell is supporting this channel. They probably don't provide the awesome taco thing, whatever. Yes. Do I have subscribers? I have no idea. Look at me. This is my rocket car. This is a rocket car. This one is probably not a good design, but we're just going to show you it working here. So, throttle. I decided to go with the reverse trike with two wheels at the front, thinking it might stop the wiggles, but apparently the wiggles still happen, so disable that and just watch how fast we go before things explode. Taco Tuesday. Oh, look at that. I'm just gonna pin that here because I might need this. Or not. Things are bouncing. Oh, and we're airborne. Yeah, so like, enable pitch control. And now, let's see if I can actually fly this thing like a missile. And now, actually, turn off the deploy. So now I actually have a little plane here. let's see how fast I can make this. Let's see if I can make this land. Hey, Johante! Johante, are you coming? You're from Norway. Norsk. I heard about them in the news. Is it Norway that has the big fund the oil money goes into? And they were basically talking about how some analysts decided that it was too risk averse, basically, and that they should put more money into stocks. Okay, I'm gonna slow this thing down, and then I'm gonna EVA her at the last minute. Ah, I thought she would survive, but no, because it was gonna explode. Well, yes, we should do that. So we should work on fixing some things. Let's recover the vessel. Eating the cookies. Yeah, I heard the stock market in Europe pretty much jumped up just because somebody said, oh, Norway needs to put more of its giant amount of money from oil into stocks. Oh, yeah. That went into hypersonic. I didn't actually look at the numbers on it. So I'm going to show you how to, if you don't know, this is how we kind of get things, how we make these things work. Bloodhound, that's my original version of the Bloodhound that I did. Actually, it's not the original because it has this engine. Still, I can show you this working nevertheless. Like, let's try this, I'm definitely going to set the friction control to nothing. Okay, Ricky Bobby? No. Haven't you seen the American Eagle? That nose is really close to the ground. What are the odds that this thing smashes into the ground first? So if I do a quick save, I can get that to the North Pole. What you do is you open up the save file and you search for the vessel, Bloodhound, right? And what you'll see is here it says pre-launch. No, you want to set that to landed. Right, and then down below it are the latitude and longitude. You want to set your latitude up near the North Pole. So I set it to about like 85 degrees. Save that. Come back to the game. Hold F9. And you're like magically at the North Pole. You're on your side, but then it fixes it. You see? Bingo. Right next to the flag that I placed there. Isn't it like magic? It is. It's like magic, I tell you. I guess I don't have action groups enabled. Let's activate this engine. I'll have stability control enabled on this thing. And then I shall reduce the traction control to zero on this, right? So we'll have... Oh, it's not traction control. Friction control. No friction. We don't want friction here. And this one, yeah, we need to switch the mode to jets. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, yeah. But we can actually look at it from the inside. Ooh! I like the way that you can see these clouds just flying past. 250 miles per hour, meters per second. There's the sun there. We are cheating a little. Let's fire up those jets. Oh, these apparently are not isolated. Let's just hit the space bar. Yes. And let's take a look from the inside to see how fast we go. I'm drinking beer, but it is a beer that uses tea instead of hops because it was invented during a hops shortage, during the great hops shortage. And I like it. It tastes a bit like kombucha, but it's also alcoholic. So, you know, not bad in many ways. Oh, 100%. Let's come out of the cockpit. Yeah, this thing is just terribly slow. Not enough thrust in anything, to be honest. We're about to run out of liquid fuel. We're about to run out of anything. I wonder what happens if I try to pitch up. No, it's actually doing just fine. The TB is called Golden State of Mind. It's by Ale Industries of Oakland, California. And, they also do a version with cherry in it. Now, yeah, these are not real beers. They also do plenty of real beers. But I just really like this one. It did not get to go supersonic. It failed before hitting the supersonic. I am so sad. I don't know why this one is so much slower. It's very disappointing, to be honest. But hey, it hasn't exploded. Oh, there! I knew that front was not long for this world, and without that, we're going to slow down a whole lot. Program is me just building, you know, fast cars and seeing how fast they go. You know, let's come out zooming out here. There we are, moving across the surface of the planet. You know, one thing we could do is via the magic of the cheat menu. We can turn on cheats, infinite propellant, look at that. But we can also do some really weird things with the physics, such as drag. We could just stop applying drag and see how fast we get. I think I'm going to... Should I maybe shut down... Oh, let's set the thrust limiter on this a little lower so that it's not torquing into the ground the whole time. This is what happens when you disable drag. Maybe we should go into cheats and ignore max temperature. That's probably going to help. And infinite electricity. I like the fact that it is still showing... It's still not accelerating that fast. We could build helicopters. I thought people had enough of the helicopters last week. What I want to see is, can I reach, like, orbital velocity here? This thing is surprisingly stable. Yeah, that's my plan. We'll reach orbit regardless of drag. Will we run out of runway first? That's the real question. This will be interesting to find out. Will we reach the sky, or... Okay, actually, I wonder, is my... Oh, yes! We exploded at 1,423 meters per second. And this thing is still flying! We actually reached the ocean. I don't know how far back our target was. Okay, pardon me. Mach 1 is 7 to the 3 meters per second. Is it? 7 cubed? Gonna have to do the math on that. Yeah, I should try that again without the thing. Let's actually try that again. You kind of want helicopters? How about we build a plane, like a... Oh, I could do a coaxial thing. Yeah, we do need assault flats, definitely. We need, like, an Air Force base. Let's try this again, right? Z, 100%, stability, bang, no drag. We do have aero. Oh, yeah, let's, friction control. Whoa, stop the friction. Okay. Why is this, yeah, there we go. And I'm actually going to make the thrust limiter on this kind of lower, because I don't want this thing to crash. I don't want this thing to nose down when we run out of, I don't know, when things get too fast. Oh, that was my best speed yet. 1400. Of course, that's cheating because we had no drag. But what I want to do is see if I can get a car that goes fast enough that it reaches orbital velocity and therefore flies up. Right? Because you can do that on Minmus, right? That's really easy. The visual mod is called Stock Visual Enhancements. I should probably keep aiming towards the orbit node direction. Here we go, 800. I think I might need more suspension range. See that? What are these things strutted? Auto strut locked to the heaviest part. No, auto strut is disabled. We should have more struts on everything here. Look at that. Oh, this is so hilarious. Well, Tylo doesn't have any flat areas, so this is the nearest approximation to Tylo if you had a flat area on Tylo, because we have. We basically have no atmospheric resistance thanks to me being a cheating scumbag. How much thrust is this generating? This is generating no thrust? Flame out! Air combustion fail. Oh, you know what? We're getting no thrust from this now. I'm guessing because we're going too fast and the intake has stalled. So that is actually interesting that we basically won't get to space that way, so we might have to go back and put a real rocket engine on that. Starting to get hot. Look at those clouds. How close are we to the sea here? I guess I can put the thrust limiter back up, but it's just not going to work one way or another because we're going to. Oh! Matt, I like the way that pitched back and everything there, but we were unable to keep it straight. Okay, so let's revert that. F9, and then we'll go back to the thing, and then we'll try to make something that can actually make it to orbit, right? What do I think about the new engines, the pre-release ones, and the relative career thing? Oh, the ship. What are my thoughts on the Schiaparelli lander and the lack of rechargeable batteries? You know what? I might be talking with someone from that. Can I get a boat to orbital speed? As long as you don't mean from the water. Okay, so let's put bigger and more powerful engines on this thing, right? And let's actually get rid of the... This is the one we were working on, right? So we're going to take out the fuel cheating. That's one thing we're going to do. So let's actually put liquid fuel in this thing. And I'm wondering whether this thing actually helps. You know what? If I put, I get rid of this and I put the whatchamacallit on it. The rapier. The rapier engine. Uh-huh. And we gotta get rid of these things because these are all. Oh crap! I gotta get. Okay, gotta get rid of all these things. First thing I need to do is pull that off. So we'll put in just a regular fuel tank instead, and we'll attach this on the back. Apparently, I have not got that in the middle. Thank you. Oh, and you know what? We should replace that air intake with the better, improved, faster air intake. One that can handle the rigors of traveling at near to orbital velocity. Okay, how's this looking? Not bad. Let's actually do some auto-strutting. Auto-strutting. Yeah, so we're just doing lots of auto-strutting. Just to make sure that everything holds together. Okay, and then the next thing we need to do is lift the suspension a bit, because this thing is clearly not able to handle these high velocities without bottoming out. There, so we're cheating a little, because the real one doesn't travel that close to the surface. Okay, next, get rid of these crappy monopropellant engines and put on a real engine. Something that is truly up for the task. Vector? That could be the one. I think I might have to reduce the gimbal limit on this, though. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to reduce the gimbal limit on this. Okay, so... I could actually have just two of these things. No, I think I'm going to go with this design because it looks very similar, right? Auto struts are basically awesome. They're basically the lazy person's way of strutting things. They're strutting their funky stuff, as they say. Okay, activate engine. Switch mode. And toggle engine. This should actually be toggle engine. Toggle engine. Okay. Save that. Launch. This is totally like the White Sands missile range, but with missiles that are running along the ground. Okay, so once again, I do my save game hack. So F5, jump in here. Yes, I do want to. I think you should be landed at 85 degrees north. Oh, 85. And then reload. And as if by magic, da 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 da. There we go. Okay. Stability control. We've got this. This is set to friction. Oh, you know what? We need friction control visible because we're going to have to cut that down. So usually I start out with friction enabled just to get it going straight, and then we switch them over. Oh, wrong button, apparently. Look at that wobble. I like the fact that we're basically doing power drifts at... 100 meters per second. So oh, yes. I'm sorry, Azimech, you can't post links because that would require me to stop playing the game and do something for you. And that's effort that I don't have. It's nothing personal. It's just what happens. Okay. This might not work so well. We might have some stability issues here. Okay, so... activate engine. Oh, there we go. Nice! And then, once we get a little faster, we'll disable the friction control, and then we'll let stability control be maintained by the aerodynamic properties of the vehicle. I'm going to actually try to keep it pointing at the ground. Now let's fire this engine here. Oh, did I forget to stop cheating? I did forget to stop cheating. Cheats, infinite propellant. We don't need that. Oh! 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 No, 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 no! Okay, this is not quite as I imagined it. So what's going on here is the weight of these engines is so high that they're actually, the thing is not stable. So we need to move the center of drag further back on the whole thing. Still, it's nice that we're gaining some altitude. Maybe we can gain enough altitude that I can gain some control here. If not, I will fire my engines to try and gain altitude. Okay, we're now getting stable. You know what? I think I'm gonna do this. Oh! You know what? Maybe. Okay, hold on. This vector engine has no fuel in it. So this is the problem. We have no fuel left in this thing. We basically ran out of fuel. So I somehow need to figure out how to land this, or need to control this thing. There we go. Come on. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. Oh, okay. I didn't want to do that. Okay. Do we have any gimbals here? No? Okay. Oh, there. And we've stalled that engine. Why is that engine stalled? Toggle mode. Come on. Air breathing mode. Come on. We don't have any. We're flamed out here. Where's my liquid fuel? We have liquid fuel in here. Okay. In. No, it's not burning it. Air combustion failed? Why are we failing? We're going at 2 kilometers per second. Oh. Yeah, that's what happened. We're basically going too fast. So I could try this, but I am going to crash. Woohoo! It's maintaining such high velocity because we have disabled drag, which also disables lift. I'm curious as to where I am on the planet. I guess we ended up in this bizarre region here. Okay, let's come back. So actually, yeah, let's turn infinite propellant back on just to see if this thing is stable up until, you know, the relevant velocities, right? Activate engine, and activate this engine, there we go, and oh, friction control, zero, oh crap, here it goes, yes, and this thing is never gonna die. Oh yeah, we should add more gravity, let's do that. Oh, crap, cheats, hack gravity, no, okay, and it's still gaining gravity, gaining speed. Let's turn off infinite propellant. With 5 G's, how far, yeah, it'll fall back, okay, but we should just reload. Wow, look at this. Gravity with 10 G's gravity, we're literally rolling across the surface without anything. We're picking up speed. Traction control, not traction control, friction control. Let's get rid of some of that now. That's pretty funny. Let's, I'm guessing there's a really, really tiny. I don't know, there's a really, really tiny slope that we're rolling on. I'm wondering how fast this thing is gonna get. I like how Valentina's just going, "Wow! Look, I'm not even pushing any buttons and it's going like 200 miles an hour." This is what we have is 10 G's gravity and there's some glitch. I'm wondering if it's because the front of the vehicle is slightly lower than the back. Like, is that maybe it? Or is this like the Coriolis force because we're on a rotating body? Oh, this is great. I have no idea why this is happening. And I have we're not losing altitude. Our altitude is perfectly, exactly, completely the same. Is it? I'm just trying to think. Is it a rotating frame of reference or something? Maybe we should just turn off the friction control. There, let's do that. It's partly because we have no drag, right? So we have no drag, and we have 10 G's. So the collision physics are playing silly buggers. So I'm wondering, like, at what point? How far can we go with this? Can we take this places? Can I put wings on this and make it fly? Probably not in 10 G's. Like, look, we're almost at Mach 1. Of course, no drag. Yeah, this is clearly what's happening. We're at the North Pole and we're just rolling downhill. Yeah, I don't know. This is like really. I don't have any infinite propellant or anything enabled at this time. What's the land speed for the fastest moving vehicle at 10G with no drag and no engines? This, we are gonna set a world's first. The fa Well, I completely had not expected that. Okay, let's reset the gravity. Whew. Okay, just throttle these engines. Stability control, prograde. Friction! Cut the friction! Okay. Let's see if we can get this into the sky. Oh man, we lifted up for a brief moment. Okay, so having this two-level thing is like ridiculous. We need to reload this and bring Valentina back, right? Thanks, Chris, for going back and actually looking at that because I'm sure we will love saving that fact, 328.1 meters per second for posterity. It will be a number, a niche record. Like the fastest person to be able to the fastest person to solve a Rubik's Cube using their nose. I mean, how many people do that record? Okay, so let's actually just take this design. Okay, this is what we had, and I'm just gonna ditch this whole section on the top. I don't think we need it. I think what we need is that. And maybe this is not the best engine for it, because our thrust to mass is probably far from ideal. Should I go with a swivel? Let's go with a swivel. How heavy is it? Yeah, this is a 4-ton engine. So part of the problem was the engine was just so heavy that the rest of the vehicle would sit in front of it. So yeah, I'm thinking this will work. You know what, actually, I have one more thing I want to do here. So what we're gonna do, where is this? Yeah, I'm gonna put this adapter on the back here. Oh crap. And then I'll grab these fins and slide them backwards. as far as they'll go. I'm hoping. Let me see where my center of mass is. Center of mass is there, but if I get empty, where does the center of mass go? If I get rid of all this fuel, oh, it says it goes forward. That actually, interestingly enough, goes forward as well. Okay. Ah, there we go. So we should end up pretty good. So we'll do this. We just need to make sure everything gets strutted up again, right? Auto strut does whatever a strutty does. It can fly. And something like that. Okay. Wow, quirky Cyndaquil can solve Rubik's Cube in under 2 minutes. I have in fact solved Rubik's Cube many times, but it's mostly been by luck because I don't have the patience to learn all the algorithms. Let us move ourselves back to where we want to be to test this thing. Landed, and 85, because we like to start next to that flag for the simple reason that it means we can tell how far we've gone. Yes, we could replace the slope cone. I deliberately used the sloped cones so that it would push the nose down, so it would keep us on the ground. So maybe we'll consider that in a future iteration of this design. But strictly speaking, I'm not sure how much the aerodynamics actually matter given how we've turned off drag completely. Okay, friction control, turn that off. Okay, keep pointed. Okay, let's see how this works. Valentina! I will admit the first several times I solved Rubik's Cubes was by taking them apart and putting them back together again, because you know what? I saw it as an engineering problem. I actually wanted to see how it all worked. Wow, this thing's bouncing around quite a bit. I'm surprised by how much this is bouncing. It's like a pimpmobile here. Boom, boom, boom. Yo, I set my land speed records with the suspension bouncing high and the ground so flat. I'm moving so fast over the planet and I'm going into space. Oh, yeah, I know. I'm trying to, you know, impress the ladies with my rapping skills. Obviously, Scotsmen can't really do that. Okay. Come on. 1.2. 1.3. Of course, I could just put a bigger engine on it. That's okay. Oh, wow. It just said Bloodhound crashed into Kerbin. So the adapter crashed. Oh, man. That was harsh. You know, we could actually reduce gravity, look, and we could definitely get into space. F9. Yeah, I can do some raps if I have the lyrics, you know, like I can do Mr. C from The Shaman, like, I've listened to Move Any Mountain so many times. Yeah, I know all the words to that tune. I am a terrible person. Okay, yeah, let's friction control. Should probably get this horizontal again. This is not really what I intended to do here. Let's try and this is me. You need bigger wheels, yes. Turn off the thermals. Okay, let's actually get this thing ready because we need the friction control ready to go. 1.6! Oh, man. Friction control. to the tune of Particle Man. Friction control, ease control, nerve friction control. There we go. Maybe what I should do, actually, is make a motorcycle, because one of the problems with this thing at speed is that you do get a torque between the rear wheels and they can cause some weird interactions. So maybe we should just have a motorcycle. The clouds do look pretty darn beautiful. You know, you can't make gliders. You can make gliders in Kerbal Space Program, but there's no thermals to keep you up, despite my continued attempts to get somebody to actually mod it in. The guy that was making the wind mod, I keep asking him to add something that would make that work, but sadly, it never happens. Not because, you know, he can't do it, but because I certainly don't have the time to convince him to do that. Are ablated line nozzles typical in real life? The RS-25 does not have an ablative line nozzle, as far as I know. It gets its nozzle cooling through fuel circulation. There we go. Look, the nose of this thing is just bouncing up ever so- Whoa! Did you see that? Did you see that? It actually phased through the ground. It was going so fast that it, like, literally became at one. The landing gear was just like, what is this ground of which you speak? We don't know any ground. It just fell through it. That is really, wow. Let's try reducing the gravity, right? We're going to make this happen. Yes, we hit quick snow. Quicksand! That is, so I've reduced the gravity to even less just to see how this works. Friction control. So we can cut that to zero. If you don't have any at the start, did I put an overthruster on that this thing and buckaroo banzai? That is exactly what we are doing here. We are buckaroo banzaiing the heck out. I have the Adventures of Buckaroo Banzai Across the Eighth Dimension on DVD somewhere. I've never got anyone else in my family to watch it. I love that movie, but nobody else takes it seriously. We'll see what the top speed on this thing is. What do I think about the concept of a Niven ring? You mean like a ring world? I actually looked at the math behind ring world. It's like you configure it the tensile strength of the material required. It's essentially the same as having a suspension bridge with infinite endpoints. It's kind of fun to figure this out. But you could actually build... So, it, you know, and the strength needed to make a classical Niven ring world is basically impossible unless you can somehow figure out how to take the strong nuclear force and create a chain of nucleides. Whoa, there we go! Look, we're actually getting some sort of airborne here. What I need to do is flip upside down. There. Yeah, it's that nose is driving us into the ground there. Let's reset the gravity. Just for good measure here. In fact, I'm going to nose down a bit to balance out my vertical speed. Just to make sure that I... get there. Oh! Oh, crap. Okay, that's us. What's my position? Perihelion, 2 kilometers. Yes, I've gotten myself into a stable orbit in my rocket car. Isn't that beautiful? Yes. Yes, you could scale down. You could absolutely scale it, but the problem is that realistically using, like, conventional materials and something that can support, like, the atmospheric pressures and masses you need, you're really talking a few thousand kilometers being the maximum size of ring you can build without going into complete unobtainium made-up materials world. Certainly, okay, I guess, you know, carbon nanotubes, if you could make them dislocation free over that kind of length, you could definitely get pretty large things. But there is a way to build a ring world which behaves like a ring world that doesn't require the stupidly strong materials. It does require, you know, insane engineering and stupid amounts of energy. But hey, so what you can do is you can have a ring, and then you can have an outer ring which is much, much heavier, right? Enough mass that it wants to fall inwards. And then you basically have the inner ring runs on like a magnetic rail. So you basically have an outer ring of mass that's static and it falls towards the sun, but then you've got an interior which is spinning around fast enough on this giant rail, magnetic rail track. And then you can have a ring world. So you can have a bunch of like material which has all your machinery and stuff, and then the interior has your living space. So there, you can do that. The problem is my orbit altitude is too low. It's lower than some... Yeah, but the only place... Do you think we'll eventually hit something somewhere? It, you know, it isn't a polar orbit. Does anyone want to place bets? Unfortunately, it's going to take far too long. I kind of like the fact that this thing is just still working just fine. There, put this in a nose. Yeah, I think Silent Searchlight was correct. That nose, while it did look authentic, it did look like the Bloodhound, it does happen to have these problems with knocking the nose downwards and everything like that. Yeah, so yeah, it is. It's a monorail. Monorail, 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 monorail. Oh, I like it. By the way, this Racer 1, that was another vehicle which I was doing stuff with. Oh, I cannot switch vessels in the atmosphere. Apparently I gotta get into space before it'll let me switch. So yeah, let's fly this one. Switch to. I may have to go and get some more of this beer. I am in completely the wrong orbit. Let's target this thing. Set as target. And I guess stability control, prograde. I'm going to have to enable infinite propellant. Oh, and I'm going to have to enable torque here. Yeah, I was playing around with this thing on Minmus. You might have seen, if you follow my Twitter, you will see many videos and stuff that I produce. I sometimes put crazy ideas into target. That's what I want to go for. If you follow my Twitter, you'll see that I occasionally post videos and stuff, little things that I don't know, stuff that I do. And you might have seen me driving around. It wasn't the race car. Yeah, it wasn't the YouTube video as well. But this is a slightly different version. Let's take a look at this. Oh. Wrong way. That was my mistake. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go... Yeah, actually, that's the best way to go for now. Doesn't a long string of satellites form a Dyson sphere-like ring without any tension between the elements? Oh no, a Niven ring basically is spinning fast enough that it's like a centrifuge and it pulls you towards the walls. And you could build entire cities and have walls inside that keep the atmosphere in. So it gives you an insane amount of space, but without worrying about the differential rotation that a Dyson ring, a Dyson sphere, has to deal with. So that's the main thing behind the Niven ring. It doesn't require artificial gravity or any weird stuff that the Dyson sphere starts to talk about. Dyson was cool and all that, but hey, you know, his stuff doesn't totally work unless you have this weird technology that doesn't actually exist. There, we're now going to go straight towards Minmus! Now we're gonna get back in there. in 1 hour and 37 minutes, and we are going to hit the target. That's good. That's what I wanted. I'm flying a car through space. Yes, the Kempler Rosette is not stable, though. The Kempler Rosette is just like... it's not actually mathematically stable. You need to keep things exactly in place, and if there's any mass deviation, then it becomes even less stable. So it's not a way to go. It's a way to show off that you can do planet engineering. That's what it is. Friends don't let their sci-fi writer friends create Kempler Rosettes. I'm hoping to be able to watch ExoMars Arrival, but I have a lot of things going on, and I'm also very, very tired. Yes, the Ringworld does need to be balanced. In fact, that is a plot point in Ringworld Engineers, which is a sequel, I believe, where they are... Oh no, actually, it's mentioned in the original Ringworld, where they balance out two giant oceans, because they say, hey, these things need to be balanced. But then somebody... After the original Ringworld, a nerd went and did the math and said, hey, by the way, you know that Ringworld thing you designed, Mr. Niven? It's completely unstable. You know, let's you know, not worry about that. Anyway. Actually, that's... Valentina is probably going to die now that I realize it. Well, whatever. I can bring her back to life. I'm just going to fall down towards the surface. Okay, now, let me just see this thing. Aha! So, I need to somehow get this thing into orbit here. Well, what I want to do is wait until we find a suitable flat place to land. Pardon me, I'm just taking another sip of this fabulous beverage. Oh, I should probably slow down the time warp. And now point in this direction so that we swing around. I could probably turn off target mode. That's pretty good. We don't care about Valentina. We'll come back to her later. They will do it at 30 kilometers altitude. Add maneuver. Slow down. Pardon me. Maneuver. Slow the F down. Slow. Speed the heck up. Somewhere in there we will have a reasonable velocity. That'll do. Okay. Why isn't it not showing the warp? Warp to next maneuver. And we're going to set retrograde. Look at me falling past this thing. Minmus is being scanned by a big purple beam. Mm-hmm. That's an interesting mission. This is my race car here. It isn't using green tea. It is... just regular tea, I believe. It might be green tea. It's pretty awesome. I think the bitrate of the stream is about 2 kilobits because I remembered that was what I was told I was allowed to use. I originally had it higher, but then I found that Twitch was occasionally dropping the stream, which was not quite what I wanted. That is where I want to land, so unfortunately we're going to have to wait a little while. You can see the shadow. Okay, let's just close this menu down. I don't really care about the propellants thing. I just want to make the landing actually happen. No hops, can you even call that beer? Hell to the yes. I would totally call it beer, because you know what? I decide what I want to drink. Seriously, like, don't be a snob about this thing, right? This isn't wine, right? The beer drinkers... we get to not be snobs, right? Wine drinkers, they're like, macadamia nut wine. What kind of grape is a macadamia nut? Right? I mean, seriously, like, no. Beer drinkers, we're just like, oh, this tastes good, you know? Like, right? I'm certainly not the beer police. Exactly, right? There's no beer police. Because beer people like beer. They like to be social. They don't want to set rules. They like to break the rules. You don't tell a brewer what is and isn't beer, right? That's it, basically. Okay. Now, certainly you can argue over whether what kind of beer it is, because there are many, many kinds of beer. Okay, let's... I'm waiting for this landing spot to come around. I was up there earlier. By the way, Valentina is dead by now, right? That's okay, because Valentina will live on in our hearts forever. Okay, now... I'm gonna initiate a landing here, so I'm gonna point radially inwards. Gonna go a little further around. Okay, I think this might be it. So, I'm gonna point radially inwards. And the idea is that we're gonna just like touch down gently. And you know what? I'm going to actually go normal. Anti-normal. Because I want to raise my... I want to move this up over here. I need a much longer runway to make sure I can land properly. So I'm going to try landing this thing like a plane, right? That's the idea. Okay, radially in. It's not the most efficient way to do it, but that's okay. We're just trying to make this happen. Okay, so I need to try. I think I'm going to point my spacecraft here, maybe. Aha! No, that's not quite right. How about here? Aha! Okay, oh, crap. 647. Now we just need to get this exactly down to zero. And no more! This is not quite litho-breaking. This is, like... This is going to be a landing technique which I have previously explored, but I haven't done in this version of Kerbal Space Program with new semi-working wheels. My favorite kind of beer is the wet kind with alcohol in it. How about that? I will raise... Yes. Okay. Let's get this as close to zero as possible. 3, 2, 1. That's pretty good. Oh, crap. Okay. Now I might have to go radially outwards just to fix this. Oh, man. Totally messed it up. Still, I have more time. I'm going to have to do this again. What I'll do is, of course, I'm going to go in and modify this engine to reduce the thrust limiter. That way I can put it closer, more precisely, at the location I need. There we go. See that? Tick, oh. Tick, 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 tick. There we go. You see? We had 4 meters as the last one. I think we can get down to like 1 meter. There, 2 meters. Okay, 2 meters. That's fine. We're probably going to get some weird problems from this, but never mind. Now we need to face retrograde. Put the thrust limiter back. Wow, that is some weird, funky moiré patterns there. I bet you that is really screwing up the thing. Wait a second. Oh, hold on. It's this one. What's the button? Oh, crap. Crap, 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 crap. Crappity crap. Crap. I messed it up. Damn it. Okay. I messed up my approach because I was looking for the button that would fix this, And I messed it up. I'm so sorry, there is a problem here. Apparently Scott Manley has been replaced by a Scottish sounding moron. Okay, once again, back with the incredible Rhyme Animal, Public Enemy number one. I was trying to figure out how to look at these things, and I forget, what is the... What is that? What is it? Okay, so what we need is we need to adjust the friction control. This one needs friction. Friction control here needs to be a whole lot lower because we're going in reverse and we want this thing to remain stable on impact. Yeah, that is some bizarre alien life down there.
It's life, Jim, but not as we know it.
Okay, how are we doing? So I'm gonna switch camera angles here. This is where I find out that I'm coming in so steeply that I'm gonna actually impact the terrain instead. Nice. Oh no, we are in fact gonna make it over. So we're gonna try landing this in reverse like an aircraft. Still says 2 meters, and we're 2 meters and 2 minutes and 27 seconds away. One wheel is broken. Oh crap, really? Oh, okay, this is an F5 moment, right? Can... Oh wait, as we don't have an engineer on board. Repair wheel. Nice! That's how awesome Jim and I are. Did I just... Dr. Demento, please don't credit Star Trek into Dr. Demento. Dr. Demento is some dumb American radio show that plays novelty tracks. I'll have you know that in Britain, we play novelty tracks on regular radio. Star Trek was recorded by a band called The Firm, who had a number one hit record with it. Right, they had several other records, including Arthur Daly, Ease All Right, and Super Heroes, and a B-side called Start Reckon Across the Universe, where it was, of course, sung by a bunch of giant monsters from, kaiju monsters that were smashing up cities. So please, do not give Dr. Demento any credit for Star Trekking. He merely was a person playing. It would be like crediting me for being Bob Dylan because I occasionally play a Bob Dylan tune, right? No. The talent comes from the creator, not from the person that popularized it or whatever. Anyway. This is looking cool. Oh, it's 15 meters now, it says. Well, whatever, we'll have to... Okay. And fire engines. Gotta slow down in time before I hit that. Oh, yes. Oh, no, we're getting a little unstable here. We're picking up a bit of a shimmy. Oh, we should have had brakes on. You're right. We should have put brakes on this way. The Time Lords, also known as KLF. Yes, the Kerbal Liberation Faction. No, the front Kerbal. No, the KLF are, man, those guys were media terrorists. They are awesome. The KLF, you should go back if you don't know. The KLF, they were basically a couple of guys who they did, they had this number one record. They had several number one records. They also published a book called The Manual, where it was like, follow these instructions and you will have a number one record. And yes, they also made some really, really good tunes. And you should track down the KLF, the K Foundation, the Justified, Agents of Moo Moo. Yeah, so they made a fantastic album called Chill Out, which is really a pioneering ambient album that was recorded live in somebody's bedroom. Okay, so let's reload the quick save. Will the brakes work with no friction? Good question. Okay, let's try this again. So what I need to do is make this thing touch the ground again and no more. So I'm going to get again, we're going to touch down, and I'm going to fire the engines to make sure that we touch the ground. Oh, crap. Okay, so now we're going to touch the ground at 200 meters per second. And I'm going to enable brakes. Oh, yeah. EVA, repair wheel, board. There, fix that. How did that wheel ever get broken? I was about to... I thought they'd remove the broken wheels, because that's... I hadn't seen any in several days, but apparently they still break just as much as anything else. Okay, friction control is enabled. Traction control, drive limiter, brakes. Oh, brakes should be like 100%. Brakes, 100%. Brakes are there. And brakes are there. And brakes are enabled. And we should definitely have more friction. Yes, there's a lot of friction. We want friction out the caboose or whatever. Anyway, yeah, the K Foundation, they did, though, the KLF, they actually had a... The name came from the Kylie Liberation Foundation, Front. And it was their a record called Kylie Said to Jason. It wasn't a hit, oddly enough, but later on they then reappeared and they did a bunch of tunes which they described as stadium rock. Okay, so we're going to fire these engines. Because we want to hit the ground. And then hopefully... Okay. Let's make that... Still trying to slow it down. Oh! Okay. Well, so much for that. I was trying to do it using just the braking force. You know, one of the problems we might have is that it was trying to steer. We've reduced our speed to 80 meters per second. You know what? If I disable... disable steering. Well, steering is actually disabled already. Well, actually, we might just manage this. Hey, look at this! We totally landed down with brakes! We totally used brakes to stop! Genius!
I had faith. I delivered. This is marvelous.
This isn't, you know, particularly useful. I wonder if the thing still drives now. So let's actually just do friction control auto, traction control auto. Friction control auto, traction control auto. Wait a sec, did I disable? Yeah, everything's on auto. So now we should be able to drive around. Okay. You know what? We probably need to disable torque. Here we go. Or, you know, there's a trick you could do. Is you can go into docking mode, and if you remove the torque, we should be able to drive around like this. Not quite. Apparently, control mode is still linear rotation. Oh, okay. Well, so much for that. I was in the old days, you could use docking mode to make sure that you were able to drive, but apparently, this thing no longer works. So you just have to toggle the torque off and go into staging mode. And there you see we're actually picking up speed. Now take off and land on Kerbin. Do a 3.5 Mish G mission to Ilu. I don't know if I've got time for that. Honestly, I'm messing around with cars. Like, one thing I could do... Okay, maybe try this. Oh yeah, I should probably enable steering on this, on one of these wheels, right? There we go. Oh! And I need to enable torque again. Look at that. Up, back on its wheels. Okay, so let's make this thing move once more. Wonder if you can do this at Tylo. Yeah, let's see if we can get... You think we can get this thing up to speed? I think this will top out, unfortunately, because I don't think the engines have enough power. Wheel stress, motor... I wish there was a way... Traction control, drive limiter. Oh, no, we don't want to have drive limiters. Drive limiters? Who wants those? Yeah, drive limiter. Now, the only thing is, we appear to be turning a little. I kind of don't want to be turning. I kind of want to be going in a straight line. Well, I want to see how close we can get this thing to orbital velocity, given, especially since it only has three wheels. I think we seem to be topping out at this many. Oh, okay. Once again... Flipped, out of control, toggle torque. The problem is that I can't figure out how to engage the drive without without disabling the torque. Okay. Come on, stay still. That's right. Yes. Yeah, baby. Okay, you know what? I'm going to move this over here and tag it because I need it. Oh, crap. I did it again. You know what? Let's reload this again. Reload. Okay, I'm going to just run the... EVA again. And repair and board. Okay. This, and then time accelerate once again. Set the torque to SAS only. That would actually help. That is a very good point. Toggle. Hold on, I gotta land this thing. Toggle torque. Oh, but wait. Reaction wheels. SAS only. Thank you. That is a good idea. Reaction wheels are running. Okay, so that's great. Except I actually need this right now. There we go. Once we get closer to the surface, we'll land this thing again. I could remap the keyboard, but that would just require a whole lot of effort and break all my mental mappings. It would just be nice if they hadn't broken that particular behavior. Okay, slowing down again. And I'll enable the brakes, because why not? Oh, bit of a shimmy. Bit of a shimmy there. Hold it. Maybe only increase the brakes that are behind the landing. That way it will be more stable but brake slower. Okay, that doesn't matter. Look, we got it. We're picking this up. Right, so traction control, we want maximum... Wait, drive limiter? Yeah, it should be 100% drive because we just want as much speed as possible out of this thing. Auto struts are locked. Motor is enabled. And steering is enabled. Friction control... Yeah, let's do that. Let's do lots of friction here. But in fact, I want to have less friction on the front so that it will tend to stay straight. Ah, there we go. Okay, so stability control, prograde. Let's see if this can actually pick up some speed now. Kerbal Space Engineers devs... Kerbal Space Engineers? What's Kerbal Space Engineers? Earth Atom Antum. I actually made some... I discussed this last week, and I had people saying, you're just spreading rumors and you know, hearsay, and I'm like, well, you know, I'm telling it like based on what I know. Tracking control on the front is auto. Yeah, the traction control. Okay, let's do more drive power here. 51, 52, 53, we're still picking up speed. How close can we get to like the 100 or whatever we need? Have I played Osiris New Dawn yet? No, I haven't. I guess like there's a lot of people asking for keys for that, but I simply haven't had the time. So, you know, one thing you can do, which is interesting, I wonder if I increase the gravity, whether I will pick up speed more. No, I won't. But if I reduce it a lot, let's just take a look. This is flying. Oh, there, you see? That's how you can get into orbit. Yes. Yeah, auto strut is a new feature, and you have to enable advanced tweakables to get it. Auto strut basically is a lazy man's way of connecting one strut to another, right? Yeah, okay, I'm gonna land this thing again. I should have saved after landing. I should have saved after landing. I should have saved after fixing the wheel. Like, I was so foolish. But whatever. Reset. Oh, wow. Minmus Apoaps is really high for certain. Oh, wow. Because I was loaded with... So when you load, it takes the local gravity and figures out the orbit, right? So... Here, look at this. A Min Periaps 40 meters. I guess that's fine. But if you like set the gravity to 10 times, then you will fall faster, and then if I reload it, I will now be moving significantly faster. You see, I'll be moving at 600 meters per second. This is speed unheard of in the history of exploring Minmus. And we'll arrive at 40 meters above the surface. Maybe I can land it like this. Dark. Reaction wheels. S-A-S. I'm gonna start slowing this thing down and maybe we can land it like this. Whoa, Nelly! Everything is flying faster than we have ever seen it fly at this altitude on Minmus. It's gonna pile into the side of this mountain. Isn't this beautiful? Beautiful. Just beautiful. Oh. Okay, let's reset this. F9. Don't forget the SAS only reaction. I did that. Yes. SCS only. Okay, and V, and we'll land this thing one more time. I will land this one final time, and then we'll do something else. The most ridiculous craft I've gotten to Minmus orbit in career mode. What do you mean by ridiculous? Like, I always send stuff to Minmus. Look, take a look at Interstellar Quest. I send some pretty big things there, but I did like flying my nuclear space planes here. And then I taxied them over and refueled and everything. Okay. Oh, I love flying this thing. Yeah, I flew a lot of SSTOs. But of course, they kind of used cheaty nuclear engines, so they didn't really qualify as legit SSTOs. Okay, we're going to hit that mountain really soon. Damn, I'm out of beer, and honestly, I'm really tired, and I need to get some sleep. And fire engines. I kind of like the reverse landing here. You know, it has a completely pointless air intake on here. I'm just messing around with it. But we are able to actually get this up here. It drives just fine on Minmus. Okay, so let's put the brakes on. We've got the gravity. One thing I was showing is that it is possible to get this thing up to... So normally, right, if you drive in a straight line, you can't really reach orbit. Storytelling. God, I just made that stuff up as I went along. Yeah, the gravity doesn't seem to change as well as friction. Okay, so traction control... traction control override drives. Give us all that. Friction control, we want to have some. Well, you know what? We want to have more friction on the rear. Drive limiter, traction control auto. Okay. So, yes. I'm going to start doing this. Oh yeah, and what I wanted to do was crank this up to like 5. No. Once we get fast enough, we can get into orbit, right? All we have to do is wait for the right moment and then hit reset, and we will be flying. See, normally you would fly off into space prior to this, right? But because you have the gravity set, it will hold you down longer, and then at the opportune moment, you will escape into the sky. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it, and oh. X, there we go. Nice! Totally got into an escape trajectory. And oh, I could almost get to the moon. That's surprisingly close. Why are you saving F5? Oh, whatever. Yeah, people were saying F5 because I've landed. Oh, dear. I'm so tired. So I think this has been a pretty short stream. Yeah, this has been a pretty short stream. I'm just going to bring this thing down so it can encounter the moon. 11.4. Oh, crap. Okay, well, we're in the lunar encountering position. Ba ba baby ba 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 ba. I wonder if I can land this on the moon. That's actually something I maybe should try. I'll do that. I'm gonna try landing it on the moon, even though with infinite fuel. I don't really care. I just want to try landing the design. Let's do this. Escape into deep space. That's right. Farewell, Minmus. We've had fun driving.
But now we have a bigger fish to fry. Or a bigger moon to orbit. Maneuver, slow this thing down. Oh, that'll do pretty good. 98, 60. Yes, 18 kilometers. There we go. F5. Warp to next maneuver. Where is it? Where's the darn camera? There we go. Will I watch the ExoMars landing? I'm not sure, actually, because I got to figure out that into my other schedule. Believe it or not, I have, you know, real life stuff that does cause me to actually have to do things. And I may not have the time. I really like to watch it, but I will catch it. You're sad that you can't get tea beer in Vancouver. Can't help you on that. Just, you know, if you imagine there may be a hop shortage and someone will have to innovate. Okay, fire engines. So we're slowing the heck down. Dr. Demento. No, I'm nothing to do with Dr. Demento, darn it. I don't get it. See, I never understood, like, in Britain, novelty hit records happen all the time, right? Star Trek is just perhaps one that went worldwide famous, but we have all sorts of tunes that just keep coming up, and, you know, the Crazy Frogs and Benny Hill with Ernie, the fastest milkman in the West. Okay, 4, 3, 2, 1, 6, 4, 3, I want to get this precisely, exactly right. Oh, slightly too much, but I think I should be fine here. Let's, perihelion of 10, perimoon of 10 kilometers. Okay, let's do that. Warp here. Flying around. Where's the moon? Where's the moon? Don't want to crash into you without seeing you. Where are you, damn it? Time warp complete. Where's the moon? Oh, there it is, right below me, huh? And I'm falling in. I'm just going to warp here. We're going to aim retrograde, and then we're going to land this sucker. Oh yes, we will. Oh yes, the moon will be mine. Has Bob Dylan written it? Oh, there's the canyon, or a canyon. Oh, you know what? I should apply torque again. Normal. There we go. Okay. I have no idea where we're going to land on the surface. But it will happen. It's always cool, like, seeing some piece of the moon and saying, I think I've been there before. But I can't remember in which episode. You know, I've landed so many different places. It's really kind of interesting. Yeah, this thing has more than enough acceleration to land it safely. It's just a question of, will it land on the surface without exploding? Mm-mm-mm. American radio isn't so much stuffy as it is safe. It's so driven by, you know, being a profitable enterprise or playing to the remit or whatever. You get a lot of the commercial stations play the same, you know, handful of tunes. It's, you know, painful. It is sad. I'm so glad there is streaming radio, because then I can get BBC Radio 6, which is fabulous. BBC Radio 1 at night is great. And I gotta say, you know, I know obviously I am clearly biased because of my employer, but I happen to think that the Beats One Radio, right, with the Apple Music, is a really, really good station. It's up there with Six Music and, you know, classic John Peel and Marianne Hobbs and stuff like that. So I'm there for all that. Anyway. Now we just need to land on the surface. Okay. This'll be fun. You landed where one of the monoliths was supposed to be in Y Career, but it was nowhere to be found. Perhaps it was under the surface, because that did happen several times. Probably need to turn this like that. There we go. I wish I had some altitude indicator that made sense. Here we go. My mouse is getting sticky as well. I've no idea. There's some weird driver issue that is causing my mouse to become sticky. There's the radar altimeter. That's the thing that I'm looking for here. See down the bottom? So I need that to maintain my control or whatever. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Some monoliths were buried. Yeah, some monoliths are buried at different levels of terrain quality, right? It's not just low terrain quality. Yes, my mouse is basically randomly pausing at inopportune moments. Okay, I am going to plow into the surface probably because I may not be slowing down quickly enough here to successfully place myself on the surface. Actually, I might be able to do this. Okay. This is actually looking just fine. Bringing my thrust up a little here. Oh, there, the mouse just stuck there once again. This is why I'm not going to be playing any first-person shooters anytime soon, because something in my mouse drivers has made it decide to start pausing. It's a Logitech mouse that worked very well for many years, but my USB drivers just all seem to be getting a little confused. There we go. Didn't even break a wheel. Excellent. So now I can actually drive this thing around. I wonder how fast I can drive it. Oh, wait, wait. Brake, 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 brake. F5 this thing. Cannot quick save while moving across the surface. Oh, darn you. Darn you! Steering should be enabled as well. F5. There we go. Now we can actually start accelerating. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Windows did an update. They seem to... It was definitely in the recent one. It broke my microphone. It broke my mouse, apparently. And I'm extremely disappointed that these... You know, it is very hard. Like, if you're Microsoft, it's incredibly hard for you to QA every single combination of drivers. I'm going to just say that. So... I totally understand that they push out stuff, and it's not like it's the programmer's fault, because it's QA's job to check this, and then QA doesn't have every single possible hardware combo available. So, whoa! Okay, this is me driving, by the way, without any reaction wheels. So if I enable the reaction wheels again, I should be able to get out of this. Yep. There we go, you see? But the problem is, when they're not enabled, then the whole thing wants to pitch forward as I'm driving, which is far from ideal. I'm actually going to do this. Tell it to keep pointing prograde.
Oh, and it flipped onto its roof again.
Ah!
Oh, yes. Well, I was about to say, it appears that we're actually gaining speed, but it looks like we're slowing down now. Okay, so this has been a rather completely pointless trip stream, but hey, I've enjoyed myself, and I gotta say goodnight and farewell and Godspeed to you all. So thanks very much for tuning in. I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.